walking through scare zones just so you can see in the daylight what they look like. Let's go. I'm in Simpsons. I just got out of work. This Simpsons area is the scary clowns with chainsaws.
Chainsaw sounds!
Uh-oh! Surrounded!
So when you pass it through this way, you're gonna come up to Animal Actors on your left, and then if you go straight ahead into Kid Zone near E.T. is where Ash vs. Evil Dead is. But we're gonna go through Trick or Treat, which is one of my favorite scare zones this year because I love Sam. I think Sam's so cute. All right, let's go. Head towards Terminator, and we're gonna go through, I don't know what this one's called, Festival of the Deadliest, I think. Is this scare zone? I don't know, someone correct me. I don't know what the scare zone's called. It's my least favorite out of all of them, so we're gonna go through real quick, take a little peek at the scare zone. I'm almost there. Woo. But good news is they got rid of little stage in front of horror makeup show, because now Academy of Villains has their stage again. So take that, Irma. You got our stage back.
This is the scare zone that they did add the most since opening weekends. None of this was here.
By the front of the park, here's the Boulangerie Bakery, the Universal store is right in front of me. We're gonna turn right, which is where Shrek and Despicable Me are, and we're gonna go through the next scare zone, which has like icons from each of the IP houses. So Shining, American Horror Story, Blumhouse, Saw, and Ash vs. Evil Dead. So we're gonna go through that right now. Coming! Look just like Purge a bunch of times. But they have reset up the stuff they took down during Hurricane Irma is now officially back up. So we can show you in detail in the daylight what that's all gonna look like. And we got a little purger right here. Just one. This apartment or townhouse is set up so no one can get in. They put like little details of blood on the wire. If you are a fan of the movies like I am, you'll know these blue flowers represent that you support the purge, but you don't want to partake in the purge. So I think these are like really cool touches. They always bring you so much detail in horror movies. And like this is my favorite detail. And I think I've shown you guys the Purge scare zone like 3 times now in like all 3 videos I've posted for Horror Nights. So it's my favorite. I love it. They have the wood chipper out right here. You will get wet if you stand over this way and you see the puddles. It's really cool. We got some acting going on there. I have someone coming towards me. There's a motorcycle coming at me. There's a motorcycle coming up. Got someone right here behind me. Okay, so the stage I'm about to show you right here. I have yet to see what is on this. Someone tell me what happens here. Is there anything or is it just a random stage set up? Because I haven't seen anything for that stage yet. I don't get it. Please someone tell me what is supposed to happen there because I guess I miss it. Uh-oh. We got Abraham Lincoln. Is someone else behind me? No. Okay. I thought someone else was coming up behind me. Hack. Pretend you're videoing and you can see people coming up behind you. We're gonna go through the last scare zone, which is Invasion, which is San Francisco, where an alien spaceship crashed into it, and all the aliens are out, and the army men. And for all of you who haven't been yet this year, they have cut back on their alcohol. The bars only sell the specialty drinks and the draft beers and wine, some canned beers, and then the only place you can get full liquor is at bars like Shea Alcatraz, Lombard's, and Finnegan's, which are the full service restaurants and then the only full bar in the park. It's the only place you can get liquor now. But now that we're here, I am going to show you Invasion, my favorite. Videos because I'm here like all the time. So make sure you subscribe and like this video for more Halloween Horror Nights. Bye!